It's the Worldwide Sports Radio Network. Radio Network.
I want to lose. I want to win.
I need professional help.
Sports Betting Weekly.
Sports Betting Weekly, sponsored by EasySportsData.com. The books use data. Shouldn't you too? And this is Easy Sports Data, like the preschoolers use. EasySportsData.com.
I win here and I win there. Now what?
Sports Betting Weekly.
I want to win.
Here comes the money.
Here we go.
Money talk.
Here comes the money.
You should also check out SportsBettingLessons.com. You'll learn some old tricks because sometimes how you bet is more important than who you bet. SportsBettingLessons.com.
Let's just do it. Let's meet this thing head on. You were in it to win it.
Talk about an education.
Sports Betting Weekly.
Wow, winning.
Sports Betting Weekly.
Sit back and enjoy the show.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Welcome to Sports Betting Weekly. I am Second Half Chaz. I'm going to get the camera to where I'm getting the camera. We'll figure that out as we go. One of the things that I love about the show is that it's weekly. Because if this was a daily thing, I don't know if I would want to do it, never mind whether I could do it. Of course, we always get a lot of help, and that's the beauty of this show. We're getting some help tonight. We're going to be talking to the guys from GMF Sports Consultants. We've got Wes. Black Hawk Wes is joining us. He's bringing a guest. Now, I think the invitation did have on there plus one when I said it to him, so we'll take it one step at a time. We may hear from Mo. We may actually hear from Triple J Sports, Jonathan from San Antonio. First thing we're going to do is we're kind of going to get everybody in here and kind of make sure everybody can hear. We have had some situations before where the audio was working or the camera was working or guys are upside down or sideways or whatever the case may be. So, Blackhawk West, you can hear me okay?
Loud and clear, my friend.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tilt my camera out a little. I want to be have my heads between the sports betting lessons and the championship footballs. Mohammed, I'll talk to you in just a second, my man. John, you're still sideways.
I'm still sideways. All right. How about this one?
Oh, there you go.
There we go. Now we're working.
Now, for the guy in the top left and the bottom right, it don't matter much. But we booked our trip today, and we are actually driving because the CDC says don't travel. So we're driving to Vegas. Got to love having – being the parents of 20-year-old kids. They just don't seem to get it. But I'm planning on staying safe when I'm there. I'm going to do some gambling, but I'm pretty excited. As soon as I cross the border into Vegas, I'm going to get me the app. So I'll be talking to John about that later in the next 2 weeks after Thanksgiving. I want to know what's the best app for live action. Because as you know, guys, and we'll talk about this later in our sports betting lesson segment, if you are only betting the game, you're missing out on some opportunity. So first things first, we're doing something that's a little different. So I've got to open up my other monitor because you know what I have? I have the ability to go on here and look at that action for the live game tonight. And we talked about it last week. So last week, John, you came on, you liked the under. We watched it for a while after you left and it went down to 42. Now, what I should have done is I should have middled it. We should have middled it. And so that would have been a situation where we would have broke even. But when you could do a risk reward analysis and you say, hey, I'm going to risk this much to win this much. And then on the other bet, you make sure that you're going to win what you bet on the first bet. That's a pretty nice position to be in. How often do you middle games?
You want to know what? As I said it before, not too often. My middle games and my live betting is probably about 20% as of right now. But like you said, there was such a great opportunity. You were looking at 7 points, you know, in that over-under where you could have put yourself in a position to not only cover, but you could have hit both of them. So there's a lot of opportunities that in live, but you have to also be actively kind of watching the game and almost kind of have that app, you know, available, you know.
Being single helps a lot too, because if you're married or have children or even dogs, as you know, you're watching, you go out to walk the dog. How long are you going to be? 7-8 minutes to walk the dog? And somebody takes the kickoff back and the whole ball game has changed.
Yeah, it can change sometimes in a matter of 10, 20 seconds. You know, just one play. Sometimes they'll even lock you out, you know, depending on what app you have and everything like that. But like you said, there was tremendous opportunity where putting in the right situation, you know, if you did that in play, we could have possibly hit both of those in plays yesterday, which would have been, you know, very, very nice.
So I want to talk to you about the deal you offered us, which we're going to be pushing it, because what we know is sooner or later, all the other sports will be back. And I have talked to you for many years now. I know that you do other things besides football, but realistically, for the next 7 to 8 weeks, it's going to be mostly football.
Yeah, that is correct. Right now, obviously, we still have college football. We still have, obviously, the NFL going on. We're looking, you know, possibly in a couple of weeks with college basketball. So we obviously are hoping that that goes through. I love college basketball. And then, you know, NBA is slated kind of towards the end of the year, but most likely around that Christmas time, I think, is when we've seen, you know, NBA kind of get their schedule out and everything like that. So, you know, there could be a lot of opportunities, you know, come right in December where we have, you know, NFL for football, college, and then also college basketball and NBA.
So let's ask you, because I know when I talk to Wes, he's going to say the same thing. And I'm not a fool. I've watched it enough to realize that if I'm playing Thursday night or Monday nights or even Sunday night's games, I'm either really reducing my units, I'm going small, or I'm watching it and betting live. If I have an opinion, I'm going to bet on the game. So I had an opinion tonight. But I want to ask you, before we go to your opinion, what about those games when it's the only game on TV, more people bet it than normal, it screws up the lines? Do you take that into account when you guys are giving out your plays?
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, just because the amount of action, and not only that, the amount of time these bookmakers have the focus just on that one game, it's normally pretty close and they're normally pretty spot on. So I tend to do the same thing where not only me, but I also tell my players, you know, don't get crazy on these units, guys, especially on the Thursday game. You know, we still have Friday, and then obviously Saturday and Sunday is where we get the main bulk of our action for right now. So there's absolutely no reason to go crazy on this Thursday night game, especially with the matchup that we have tonight, which second week in a row, we have a pretty good matchup going here tonight with these two, you know, NFC West teams.
No, really, it is. That's a division that you got to think is going down to week 17. That in the NFC East, of course, one will be 11-4 and one will be 4-11. But they'll still be playing for a first-round game, you know?
Yeah, exactly. We kind of see the two top teams here, Arizona, Seattle. Seattle, last 2 weeks, I almost feel like these teams, I don't want to say trending, but everybody's seen the way Arizona won that game. You know, last Sunday with that amazing catch by Hopkins. And then Russell Wilson, probably one of the worst games I've seen him play. But we always know these division matchups are tough, especially at this time of the year. Arizona already beat Seattle. Seattle's back at home. So it's interesting to see, you know, how specifically Russell Wilson kind of responds, because he's been kind of putting that team on his shoulder right now.
All right, so I'm going to hit you up. Do you have an opinion on today's game?
I do have an opinion about tonight's game. Once again, as I advise my guys and everybody else Thursday, we are not going crazy on this game whatsoever. But I honestly do like the Arizona Cardinals tonight, even though they are on the road. And I almost kind of feel like Seattle's not in a must-win situation, but like I said, they already lost to Arizona before. They're home here. They kind of need this win to get back on momentum because they have lost the last two. But just going by the eye test, looking at the way Arizona is not only playing, obviously, offensively and also defensively, you know, Seattle doesn't really have much of a defense. They're ranked 32nd in the league for passing defense. So, you know, I look for Hopkins to have a big game. And obviously, we know Larry Fitzgerald. They also have a pretty good guy, Kenyon Drake, in the backfield, too. Seattle's missing a running game. And I think that's part of the problems that they have the last 2 weeks, is that Russell Wilson is kind of doing a little bit too much. We've seen a lot of forced throws. I think he had I remember specifically one interception in the red zone, you know, so it kind of feels to me like he's doing a little
bit too much. That was the one where he should have slid and got the first down and been first to go. My wife, Vicky, is still pissing and moaning about that. And she had no money on the game, but it was so, He had done it for his whole career. He did it three times later in the game. But when it counted the most, and I think my son, that's what it was. My son had Seattle for the first half. It was in the first half. She was mad at him. She ended up Mama Bear. Don't mess with her cub, you know?
Oh, yeah, definitely, definitely. And I mean, we've seen Russell Wilson make these plays before. There's no doubt that he can do that play. And it just, you know, I'm a Russell Wilson fan. I love the way he plays. And it was just kind of a little frustrating to watch how he played that game. Because, like I said, it almost feels like he is trying to do a little bit too much, but he kind of has to. Obviously, DK Metcalf, they're very, you know, talented wide receivers. You have DK Metcalf and you have Lockett. The last game against Arizona, Lockett had a big game. I think he had 2-3 touchdowns, 200 yards, if somewhere around there, if I'm not mistaken. You know, so he had a big game. But I really feel not having that running game is really hurting them, because the defenses have kind of homed in on that the last 2 weeks, and you can kind of tell the difference. It's tough, though, because Russell Wilson, he has an 8-1 record on Thursday night. So, you know, it's tough betting against that guy, but I just kind of feel, you know, there's one team kind of going upwards and there's one team kind of trending the other way. I'm going to go with just the eye test and just say Arizona's playing a little bit better. I'm going to take those 3 points. I got the 3 points at my local book for -105, which isn't bad. So we're going to roll with that tonight and kind of see how it goes.
All right. So for our hook fans out there, and I'm not talking Peter Pan, any consideration is saying, give me 3.5.
There is, if the 3.5, because since I got it at 105, then you could, you know, obviously it all depends on what your book is offering. You could play that. That's a key number. Those 3, the 7s, the 10s. I normally don't recommend buying points. Obviously you don't want to pay more juice than you have to, but sometimes on those key numbers, you might want to look into that. So
well, you know, when it's -125 already, then buying the hook makes it expensive, but -105.
Oh yeah.
It's a dime, right?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Then you're almost back to, you know, maybe 115 or somewhere. So it's almost kind of worth it at that point, especially at those prime, you know, those spread lines with the 3s and the 7s. So that's definitely something to take in consideration, depending on what your book has that line at.
All right. So you muted yourself again there. I think maybe there you go. Okay. So okay. Here's where we're at. It's about a quarter of the way through. We're going to be talking a little bit of everything. We're going to talk some sports betting lessons. We're going to talk some Thursday Night Football live action. We're going to talk some college football. We're going to talk some NFL football. Can you hang around? You want to listen to other opinions, or do you got to go?
I'm going to head out because I'm going to try to take advantage of this in play. After last week, I see what happened. So, you know, I'm actually going to be pretty tuned into this game to see if I can try to take advantage of one of these sides, and we'll see how it goes. So I'm actually
We're going to look for opportunities, and Wes and I will hop on it. Last week, we got the Colts +6.5. They went down 10-3. And that first half, I like when I'm going live, the first thing I'm doing is, and I'm not going in game, I want my money. I love getting that money and turning around, being able to use it in the second half. So we will talk again next week. Remember now on Instagram, GMF Sports Consultants, and you're basically going to get all your plays. Now, here's the thing. If you're betting any kind of money, say you're betting, I don't know, Wes, what's your average play?
I mean, I'd prefer not to say that.
Okay. Is it 2 figures or 3?
3 usually.
Okay. More. So say you're betting $100. That's a normal bet. When I'm in Vegas, I don't bet $100 when I'm sitting at home banging 18, 20 games. But when I'm in Vegas, I pick 1 or 2 games and I'll watch it. I'll watch them in my room on my phone. Let the kids drink all day because I can't be up. You know, they could drink for 14 hours, those kids. I can't keep up with that. But so you're betting $100 and you're doing your own handicapping. You know what? For a unit and a half, this guy's going to let you know every opinion he has for the rest of the football season. And even if you could say, screw you, GMF, I'm going the other way. It's a unit and a half, for heaven's sakes.
Yeah.
I think you're crazy not to take advantage of it.
It is crazy. I almost tell people just the value from the information that I'm going to give you alone. Just how to control your bankroll, like how you're talking about units. There's maybe a lot of people who are just getting into the game that don't understand units, what you should be betting. Just general knowledge alone, what I'm charging is well worth it. Even if we don't ever win a play, just the information you're going to get as a newcomer, I feel is just worth that price point alone.
You're preaching to the choir, my man. All right, go get him. Good luck with the game. We'll be following it. We'll talk soon.
Gentlemen, thanks again. I appreciate you guys having me on. Good luck to everybody. Thank you, guys. Good luck tonight.
All right, so what we're going to do real quick here is we're going to take a break, and we're going to just go and do here's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and talk about the sports betting lessons. I think it's time to talk about the sports betting lessons. What we're looking at with the sports betting lessons, and you know, it's so funny because I was talking about John with the world that he lives in and getting his plays just to have that second opinion. Well, you and I, Wes, we do it all the time. I'm not sure if you and Muhammad talk all the time, but you and I talk all the time. And sometimes we go the opposite way. Sometimes we fade. Sometimes we tail. It really doesn't matter. Just having that that second opinion. So here's our sports betting lessons tip of the week. And really, this is courtesy of our friends at sportsbettinglessons.com. Last week it was get a membership card. The first thing I'll do is I'm checking into a new hotel when I get to Vegas. I'm going to go into the MGM. The reason is the kid got us a suite at the MGM. I'm going to the MGM. And I'm going to hop on and go right to their window. I may not even go to a room. I'm going to go see the pretty lady, sign up, and get my card. This week, though, what we're going to talk about is if you're only betting the game, you're an idiot. It's that simple. If you're only betting the game in any sport that you bet, you're an idiot. It's that simple. I don't need to say anything more to you, Wes, because you understand that concept.
Well, and that's, you know, I like to call it sports investing. So if you're only betting the game, that's gambling. You know, there's risk, of course there is, but you know, you can lay money pre-game, but you got to watch the game, and you could find a way to protect yourself from the loss, or like you said, you can find a way to get paid immediately first, second half, and then you're up 2-0. Well, now you can be a gambler a little bit, but if you're only betting the game and not watching it, go to the crap table, roll your dice.
I'm going to tell you some numbers. Here's the numbers that I posted earlier today on social media. The home teams last week went 8-6. It was like 52%. If you bet 14 games and you went 8-6, you got most of your money back. Good for you. And trust me, I'm old enough to understand breaking even ain't negative. Most people talk breaking even like it's negative. It ain't negative. It's a positive thing. But if you bet them for the first quarter, those same plays were 10-4. Now, I'm not sitting there and telling you bet all the home teams. I'm just saying it's like this every single weekend in college and every single weekend in the pros. You're going to see it. But check this out. In the first half, those same 14 games, the home team was 12-1-1. 12-1-1. You go 12-1-1 on anything, and I always use the analogy, if over the last 14 weeks, my kids took out the trash 12 times, one time they didn't, and one time I had to take it out, I'm a lucky man. And it really becomes part of looking at the game. And that's when we talk about our easy sports data, why it breaks it down. Because as you know, when they switch sides of the field, when they go into the locker room, Wes, things change.
Yeah, they sure do. And what you just said about the first quarter, the first half, I mean, that's one of the things to look at. And what's great about that is, you know, you talk six bets a game. Well, you got your first quarter, you got your first half. At that point, the pregame action on this spread, that means absolutely nothing because you just went 2-0. Or if you bet them all, you probably did a little bit better than that. So by the time you get to the second half, you've already won twice. That whole deal of only playing the game and the outcome, and that's, again, you're an idiot if you only have the game. That first quarter matters. That first half matters. And what we learned last week is when a team goes down early, you get a lot of points and some good value for jumping on that dog. I love that in tonight's game. That's really what I'm looking for in tonight's game. Tonight's game, you got – two teams that have played each other, and the last three times they played each other, the margin of victory is 3. So to jump on the 3 points for tonight's game, well, you're basically betting on a push. So I'm looking to take points on the team that goes ahead, and you're going to find some value there like we did last week, probably a winner. Vegas is not off that far. If we find 7 points, that's a win.
Well, and as you know, in that live action, most of those numbers you're playing have a half next to them.
most of them do have a half next.
You're not
going to
get a push in live action.
But
usually,
you're better off on the dog with that half point. The first half, you know, I really like Zona to the over 13.5 for the first half. That's two touchdowns. But if you wanted that same on Seattle, it's 14.5. Well, that hook at 14, that matters. So if you think they're going to score two touchdowns, fine. But three scores, that's too many. So that's just too many, especially on a half. So you're right. Too many times that hook burns you.
Yeah, I agree 100%. No, there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. All right, before we go to break and listen to some words of advice from other peoples, we're going to check in with Muhammad. Muhammad.
Yes, sir.
What's your opinion Thursday Night Football tonight?
I'm not taking anything pregame. I don't like it.
All right, so you're really, really low on the mic. I can't hear you hardly at all.
Give me one second.
You're not muted. You're just really, really quiet.
Can you hear me better now?
A little better.
All right.
Don't be afraid to yell either. My wife says it all the time. Why are you yelling? I'm not yelling. I'm Italian.
Well, I don't have anything pregame, and I probably won't take anything pregame. I'm going to look for, I mean, who's going to drop? Who's scoring first? And at that point, I'm hopping on the dog. I do like over 27.5 for the first half. Both teams are going to put up points. And, I mean, Seattle's not they're not short of receivers. And that Seattle defense is pretty bad.
No, Seattle, really, their overs are out of line because they can't stop anybody. Almost everybody scores on Seattle. It's like, we're going to Seattle. Yay, we're going to score.
Yeah, well, and I'm going the other way. I'm not taking it, and I'm not putting my money on it. But Seattle wins this game. I just don't know if they cover.
And that's the thing. That's the beauty of the live action. You can be wrong. Your opinion could be 100% wrong, and yet you could cover yourself and make up for it. And again, the first thing that I do is I go one bet at a time. I try to find a bet that I might be wrong in, and I'll go ahead and hop on it. But what I always remind people, Muhammad, is you can't just do it to do it. You got to be watching the game. You don't know why. I've had times where – you know, I looked at a game, but I was wrong. And then I look, and you can't see the field. It's snowing so heavy. And it wasn't supposed to snow till that night. Or you look and you see what happened. Well, your best receiver caught the ball at the 2-yard line, got knocked out of the game, fumbled. They picked it up, ran 98 yards the other way. But you don't know that, and you just can't go blind. You really have to, as John from GMF Sports Consultant said, you got to be invested.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, college, I mean, we've got 4 or 5 games going. If I go over to Wesley's, I mean, he's got a projector, a TV in the kitchen. He's got the flat screen going. I mean, that's really the only way to make your money.
Yeah, but it is work. It is work. All right, so when we come back from break, what we're going to do is we're gonna hop into some college football. You're listening to Sports Betting Weekly.
It's the Worldwide Sports Radio Network.
Edward Lehman has been a trusted insurance advisor for over 16 years with insurance solutions for auto, home, commercial, life, and retirement. He's located at 54 Sunnyside Boulevard, Suite H in Plainview. That's just 1,000 feet south of 495. Local agent, local advice. The time to think about insurance is before you need it. So do yourself a favor, and before you pay your next insurance bill, give Ed and his team a call, 516-935-3900, or visit him online at www.allstate.com/EL. Edward H. Lehman Insurance is your trusted insurance advisor.
Do current market conditions have you nervous? Our experienced team of financial professionals at Heritage Harbor Financial Associates understands that no two investors are alike. We all have different goals, needs, and appetites for risk. That's why the one-size-fits-all approach does not work, especially when planning for retirement. At Heritage Harbor Financial Associates, we analyze your unique investment style so that you can work toward your individual retirement goals on your terms. Heritage Harbor Financial Associates can help you take steps to reach your retirement goals by providing a wide array of financial products to fit your needs, even for the risk adverse. Give us a call at 631-331-6599 to learn more or to set up an appointment with one of our financial professionals. You can also find us on the web at hhfa.org or on Facebook at facebook.com/hhfa.org. Our number again is 631-331-6599. That's 631-331-6599. Investments in stocks, bonds, and mutual funds and variable annuities are not FDIC insured and are subject to fluctuation in value and market risk, including loss of principal. Heritage Harbor Financial Associates offers securities through AXA Advisors, LLC, New York, New York. Member FINRA, SIPC. Annuity and insurance products offered through AXA Network, LLC.
Be fearless at MMA Long Island and Seituha Karate. Located at 28 Cold Court in Ronkonkoma, MMA Long Island is the martial arts school for you if you want to learn combat-proven techniques. Build confidence, discipline, and self-esteem while learning real martial arts to fight back against bullies, predators, and peer pressure. MMA Long Island offers group and private lessons for all ages and levels in traditional Goju-Ryu Karate, MMA, and self-defense. MMA Long Island is one of Long Island's most affordable martial arts schools. There are no promotion, belt, or membership fees, and family discounts are available. All classes are taught by 7th degree black belt Sensei John Benedict with over 30 years teaching experience. So whether you want to get in the ring or protect yourself and your family, MMA Long Island can help you reach your goals. Visit MMALongIsland.com. That's MMALongIsland.com or call or text 516-381-9660. That's 516-381-9660.
It's the Worldwide Sports Radio Network. Radio Network.
Sports Betting Weekly.
Viva Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas. Viva, viva Las Vegas.
Sit back and enjoy the show.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Welcome back to Sports Betting Weekly. I'm sitting here with a mouse that's not working, which means I can't unshare my screen, and that's always a lot of fun. So I have no idea what the hell's going on with this. There we go. Let me see. I saw it on there. So anyway, I'm going to get back to talking to Wes. Hey, Wes.
Yeah, I'm here.
Technology, a wonderful thing.
Oh, man, it's great. It's great. In fact, now that you're saying what you're saying, I can you see my video? Can you see the...
Oh, yeah, I can see the game going on behind you, but I can't seem to get my mouse here to work, which is causing me some serious stress because haven't had that happen. And, of course, without a mouse, you know, it's funny because the producer for the other shows, Speedy Pete, he can fix anything.
Yeah.
But I got a frozen mouse here, and I don't know what to do and how to get that unfrozen because it ain't working. And so let's see what I can try. Switch out the battery here. So anyway, we're going to get back to college football and I'm going to listen to you. There we go. Look at life in the battery lane.
Oh, there we go. So it was something on your end with the video.
I am in a confidence pool that you and I have talked about. I'm not doing bad, but I'm not doing good because every single week there's an upset. But it isn't, you know, a 7-point upset. It's not even a 10-point upset. These are 14, 15, 17-point underdogs winning the game on the field. And how do you pick those?
Well, I'm starting to look at dogs because I think that some of the quality of these wins on certain teams, I think is really overstated. If you look at an Indiana, and I'm not saying that because I'm an Ohio State fan, but if you just look at Indiana's body of work this season, or even if you look at Penn State, it could go to the opposite. I think Indiana's 4-0 I don't think they've really played as great a teams. I mean, their big win was against what was then ranked number 8, Penn State. But really they haven't played a ton of great teams. And then you look at Penn State, and I think they're a much better team than what's on the field right now. So this week coming up, I like dogs, and there's a lot of big spreads. And I say, what do you say? Not with my money.
That's it. Not with my money.
Not with my money. You know, even Ohio State, I at 20 and a half points, I just don't think, they haven't proven to me that they're going to beat a team like this by 20 and a half, but you're going to look at Clemson this week. And that spread is over 30. Bama, the spread is over 30. So I just stay away from those high price games. And I'm looking for value and taking some closer games, less points, where I think the team has an opportunity to win outright. I love UCF this week. I think that Cincinnati is, you know, they're playing well, they're undefeated, they have a top defense in the country, but you got to ask yourself in that situation against who. So you look at UCF and the quarterback play and that passing game and how many points they can actually put up. Does that Cincinnati offense really live up to what the statistics have shown when they're playing from behind or when they're playing against a team that could score in 7.3 seconds? So I'm looking for the value and I'm looking for the dogs, at least in this week. There's just too many big spreads. I love Florida, but if they win by 28, that's not the same as the 31 spread. So that game now becomes a walk away to me.
Yeah, no, you're absolutely right. And that's the other thing. You know, don't get me wrong. We preach live action. We do it on the show. And actually, you're a little, your camera there, your TV is a little behind what I'm seeing. Yeah. So I'll keep it down. Yeah. There's nothing.
Well, I got the TV to the right.
Okay.
And so the camera, it comes through the Roku. So
I had to go downstairs, grab the remote, pause the game, talk to my wife for about a minute or so, turn the game back on and go back upstairs. And she goes, "What was that all about? Sweetie, you were ahead of me. And you were screaming before I was seeing the play, and it was just ruining the game for me. Plus, she was on the other team. I think it was during the World Series. But
you can't just
do that. You can't sit around. And even in those big spreads, like you said, if you win by 28, you got to feel pretty good about yourself. But if you're given 30 and a half, it don't do me any good.
No, and if I wanted to play that game, if I wanted to play Florida or I wanted to play Bama or Ohio State even, I would look to the team over under and find it that way rather than trying to get them to win by 30. How about just watch the game and see if they're going to go over 24 points in the first half? This game that we're watching right now, I think it's important to mention the spread now for the first half is 7.5. And
so no, it's time. We're going to officially stop what we're doing. We're not going to be talking about anything in the future. We're going to go to the present because really all live action is the present. So what happened is Seattle, was that the opening drive for Seattle?
That was the opening drive for Seattle and bigger, even bigger than the first half being 7.5. I'm looking at a plus 180 payout at 6.5, getting 6.5 for Zona. So that's my play right there. I'm on the Zona there. And even at a minus 135, I'm still taking that plus 7.5 for the first half. This Vegas has this at a 3-point game. So there's not going to be any 7.5 point or 6.5 point wins.
All right. So let's see here. I got a lot of options. I got Arizona from plus 3.5 up to plus 9.5. And when I'm doing live action, what I'm looking for is the yin and the yang. You can't be greedy. The yin and the yang are the point spread versus the VIG. And that's the odds. Because, you know what, at minus one, say minus 170, 7.5, minus 129, 6.5. Am I going to kick myself if it lands on 7 and for 40 points I lost instead of winning something, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, but you got to ask yourself, is it going to happen? And again, 7.5, I would take it if it was plus 180, if it was minus 130. At minus 200, I wouldn't touch it. I mean, anything beyond minus 150, I wouldn't be playing it. But at minus 135, that's okay to me. But the main reason it's okay to me right now is because I love this first quarter, plus 6.5. Seattle hasn't had Zona hasn't had the ball. And I think that they're going to score. Even if it's a field goal at that point, you got Zona. This is the number one offense going against the number 32 defense. So I think that's a great value right there. Plus
right,
6.5.
That's what we'll do then. I'm gonna. What's that movie I like? The movie where Oh, it's Trading Places. Trading Places, yeah. where Billy Rob, was it Billy Robinson? What's his name?
Billy, I what was Eddie.
He set the number on soybeans or whatever.
Yeah, he did.
Trading. So I got plus 154. First quarter.
Cardinals zone up +6.5 first quarter.
That's it. We'll see what happens. But, you know, it's kind of fun. We're betting live.
Technically, in your
jurisdiction, you know, this is not a gambling show. This is all for entertainment purposes only. Until you're cashing, you know. All right, so we're going to bounce over to Muhammad. Muhammad, Saturday. Right. Actually, no, that's not true. We used to do our shows, as Wes knows, we would record them after we were off the radio. We record the podcast on Thursday. And we didn't come out till Friday, sometimes Saturday. So we didn't really talk about Friday. But technically, with college football, there are some opportunities on Fridays. All day Saturday, and hell, the last few weeks, Tuesday and Wednesday too. But what do you think about college football, Muhammad? You got any plays that are just jumping off, screaming at you?
Well, and I paid for it, I think, in week 5, but I've been fanboying Florida. Florida's been paying, I mean, nonstop. I mean, they're scoring points. North Carolina is a surprising one. They've got one of the top running backs. I think his name's Devontae Williams. I was telling Wesley about him, I think, 3 or 4 weeks ago. That guy is just a touchdown machine. But for this week, I'm a little hesitant. I'm looking at Ohio State, 20 and a hook. And I know Wesley probably doesn't like that one, but that's a good one for me. And then Coastal Carolina. Coastal Carolina is going to end up putting – I mean, they're a 3.5 or 5.5 favorite against Appalachian State. And that's the only two games I like so far. Not a good week for college, in my opinion. Not a good week for college.
Many times with those big spreads, Ohio State games, Clemson games, Alabama games – you know, I'm betting the first half, and then if I'm losing at halftime, I'm doubling down on the second half. And golly gee, you don't lose both of those bets very often. Of course, if they're winning at halftime, you're not betting a big bet. But Alabama second half, Clemson when they're down, Ohio State when they're down, they what they do is they make the team that led after 30 minutes pay for 30 minutes is what they do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and again, these teams, I mean, it's really. You know, they probably don't make it on the first drive, and then you get them the ball back, and there you go. You've got points, and you go with the over. First quarter and first half have been paying phenomenal over the last few weeks.
Yeah, and we call him when you know, because he was on the team that you mentioned earlier in the year. I think they finally didn't cover Coastal Carolina, but they're your personal ATM machines when you could find them. Now, one of the things that I do is I live and breathe by ATS records, because what I do is, okay, when we put in the data for our Easy Sports data, I think this week, I want to say there were 112 teams, 66 games, 112 teams. Well, you can't really get a feel for 112 teams. But when you look at their against the spread records, and I use covers because covers will let me sort it, all of a sudden I got, you know, a half dozen teams that are covering every game, maybe 9 teams that are losing every game, because I don't care why I'm betting you. Sometimes I'm betting against you. I don't really like the other team. I just don't like you. It's really that simple. So, you know, when you got games like that, now Appalachian State, they've got a pretty good football team. They've got a pretty good program. But, you know, they're not very often going to get almost a touchdown.
No. It's rare. And Wesley said this earlier, that they've got a running game. That's probably as good as it gets against Coastal Carolina. That's all they've got at this point.
Yeah, and so we slide out of college football. Now, what I'll do is I'll go through, and I'll make most of my plays on Friday for Saturday, and I break them down. I do it a little bit differently. I break it down in waves because I have I call it my Caliente system that we use when we go down the Caliente Sportsbook in Tijuana. And they got sportsbooks all over Mexico. It's great because we did a cruise. We had 2 stops in Cabo and somewhere else. And both places, I ended up at a Caliente's casino, betting live on the games that were there. But what happens is you've got four games. I'll try to isolate four games at the 9 o'clock games out here. It's 9 o'clock, of course. The noon games, the 3 o'clock games, the 7 o'clock game, 5 o'clock. College football comes in waves, waves and waves and waves. So I'll like to do that. And if I can find four, then I'll bet the parlay too. Small unit parlay, but it gets, you know, plus 1234 for a dollar, you get $12. And so, you know, even if you throw a 10 buck four teamer on there and you're betting $100 unit, it's like winning another game. So absolutely, that's what I'll try to do. And then I'll pick the best bet from all. So I like my best bet at 9 o'clock, with my best bet at noon, with my best bet at five, with my best bet at seven. Now, I have had weeks where that 7 o'clock game, I hedged it. I said, you know what? I'm tired. I've been watching football now for 14 and a half hours. I really like San Jose State over Nevada, but I'm betting Nevada for 150 bucks, guaranteed myself 115 bucks for $20 or $15, and I'm going to bed. And that's kind of how my Saturdays will sometimes wind down.
No, here we are, I think 11 o'clock is our start times. And just like you said, they come at waves, and you find two games at the 11 o'clock round, and you find another two at the 3 o'clock. And by the end, you're probably just watching one game, maybe two, and they just keep paying. And I double down. And it turns into a great day. And Sundays is where it gets tricky.
When you're winning, no doubt. When you're winning, it is a great day. Of course, you know what? We all have days where we're not winning, and that'll be part of our sports betting lessons as we go forward. You have to accept the fact that it's just like when you grab a racing form. If you've ever been to the horse races, some days you just aren't reading the form right, whatever it's the track, whatever it is. But you have to adjust to that, and you can't just assume. I had a guy on Facebook, I think it was, somebody else put a post out of an opinion, and the guy said that you should never do that. And I said, as soon as the word never came out of your mouth, you lost all credibility with me, because A, you haven't been alive long enough to realize whatever can go wrong will go wrong. And B, in sports betting, never, ever say never, because what you don't think will happen as soon as you say that. Oh, it can't come up red 15 times in a row. Yes, it can.
Jets winning outright. There you go.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. All right, so let's look at some NFL. We got a few minutes before we're going to hear some more opinions. So before we do that, let's talk some NFL. Now, tonight's game, let's see where we stand. We got 6 minutes left, and we're getting the ball back, right? All right.
I think so.
We're getting sacked on third and two.
Oh, and we're getting them.
There he goes. Go down.
We're getting the ball back with some pretty good field position, too.
It's so fun watching a game with my wife, who is such a kind soul that she'll root for, unless it's against her team, which is Baltimore now, she'll root for me. And she always screams, get him, get him, get him! And every get him as the, you know, 6'7 defensive end is trying to get this little, you know, 5'10 guy in Arizona, every get him goes up an octave. So she gets really, it gets higher and higher and higher. It's pretty funny. But yeah, so we've got 5 minutes now. I was on the over for this game from the get-go, but I want to say, was it 10 for the first quarter? I don't even remember what I have, to be honest with you. What did I have for the first quarter? Any guys remember looking what the first quarter line was on the total?
I wasn't looking at the third quarter.
Let's see what it is. I got it. I just don't know what it is. 10.5. So I need a touchdown. That field goal ain't going to do me any good. I need a touchdown on that play. So we'll see what happens. We're going to be watching that live play. But when we come back, we're going to talk some Sunday football. Before we go, I want from each of you guys one game where once you say the name of the team that you like, I would be a little surprised.
You got
Muhammad.
It.
Go with Muhammad first. He's the guest.
You want that now?
Yeah, before we go. Just the name of the team.
Panthers.
Panthers. Panthers. Why do I know that name? Who are they playing?
Detroit.
Okay. Blackhawk West.
Cincinnati.
All right. When we get back, we're going to talk about both of those. You're listening to Sports Betting Weekly.
It's the Worldwide Sports Radio Network. At championshipfootballs.com, they offer a 100% money-back guarantee on every single souvenir football that they sell. The coolest present they'll open that day, guaranteed. There's nothing worse than trying to find the right gift for somebody that already has everything. Whether that special present is for a New England Patriots fan or an Ohio State Buckeyes backer. Maybe Grams is a lifelong New York Giants supporter. Or your brother-in-law is a 12th man living in Seattle. Know a member of the Michigan State Alumni Association? Is there a better Father's Day gift for someone who's a Baltimore Ravens fan? Send them the coolest present they'll open that day, guaranteed. Now, if your favorite pro team is the Buffalo Bills or those Minnesota Vikings, well, they're sorry about that. Also, if you're a New Mexico State Aggies or Tulane Green Wave alumnus, not much they can do. After all, the name isn't nice effort. You had a pretty good season, footballs.com. The name is championshipfootballs.com. The coolest present they'll open that day, guaranteed.
Hey, this is an important message. I'm Second Half Chaz from Sports Betting Weekly. Sports betting is supposed to be a hobby. It's supposed to be fun. If you're hurting yourself by gambling with money you don't have, check out our website for the Gamblers Anonymous phone number.
When Vince Young scored on 4th and 5 in the 2006 Rose Bowl, two things happened. The Texas Longhorns won the NCAA title, and championshipfootballs.com was born. From Texas to Alabama to Ohio State, and now for Super Bowl winners too. championshipfootballs.com is the place for the coolest present they'll open that day, guaranteed. Now, 10 years later, championshipfootballs.com has the autographs too. See if any of these names remind you of a special time in your football life. Michael Bennett, Lou Holtz, Joe Montana, Devin Smith, Jameis Winston, Rocky Blyer, Rocket Ishmael, Ara Parsegian, Mike Stonebreaker, Chris Zorich, Luther Bradley, Todd Light, Tony Rice, Lawrence Taylor, Dave Casper, Marcus Mariota, Rudy Rudiger, David Tyree. Enter the promo code RADIO and you'll instantly save $50 on any of the championshipfootballs.com autograph footballs. championshipfootballs.com. The coolest present they'll open that day, guaranteed.
It's the Worldwide Sports Radio Network. Radio Network.
Sports Betting Weekly.
You keep lying when you ought to be truthing. And you keep losing when you ought to not bet.
Sit back and enjoy the show.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Yeah, unfortunately, I've known a few too many cronies in my day who kept losing when they shouldn't have been betting. But that's part of it. You know, you can't win if you don't bet. But if you're losing, you gotta take it easy. So we're gonna do a couple things. We gotta talk about the prop me. Now, I think both of those games you guys had mentioned, one was Cincinnati, and that's on the prop me's contest this week. And the other one was, who was the other one? It was Carolina. Who are they playing again? Carolina? Why am I missing?
Detroit. They're playing Detroit.
Oh, yeah, it is not. So one of those games is in that Prop Me contest. You just download the Prop Me app. It really is a pretty cool contest. You pick the props. They go from 1 to 10. You get 10 a point for each win. If you're 100%, you go 10-0, you double, the winner gets a championship football, souvenir football of their choice. And they really are. These championship footballs are the coolest present they'll open that day, guaranteed. So let's talk about Carolina first. Carolina, I would say that would surprise me only because right now, both of those teams are not with my money team, both Carolina and Detroit. So talk to me, what's going on?
Yeah, I mean, if we're looking at it, let's talk about the last two games they played. They played Tampa and they played Kansas City, which, we both know what those two teams are at. But they played it pretty close. And first half in Kansas City, we saw what they were doing. They were, pretty close. And their biggest downfall is third quarter. But you look at their running game with Mike Davis. I know Christian McCaffrey's, I don't know if he's still out. He's questionable. But Mike Davis is putting up numbers compared to other running backs. But if you look at the teams that they've lost to so far, right, they've lost to Las Vegas, which is not a bad team. That's 6-3. Kansas City, they've lost to Tampa twice. So, I like them. You also look on the other side of the ball. Matthew Stafford is probably not going to be playing because of COVID. So I like my chances there. It's a well-coached team. They played two teams that were – they were in it up until the end. So that's my biggest surprise for the weekend.
Well, and you know, it really is this year, more than ever, you have to really hesitate if you're going to bet games early, because though the advantage of course is the line doesn't move, the disadvantage is contact tracing. We never had contact tracing as a handicapping issue ever. I didn't know what it meant. Be honest with you, last year somebody said, well, you know, I'm worried about contact tracing. I'm an intelligent guy that would have no idea. I would have to say to them, and I do this. If someone says a word to me I don't understand, I don't let them continue, because I realize I may have lost all context if I don't know. And I would say, I have to interrupt you just for a second. What does contact tracing mean? I wouldn't have known that, you know?
And one last point I want to put. Matt Rhule, coach, he has no problem going for it on fourth down. I mean, it could be fourth and five, and he will go for it. And he's shown it against Kansas City and Tampa now. It worked for him against Kansas City. Not so well against Tampa towards the end. But a coach that's ready to just, you know, take a chance on it, that sits well with me.
Yeah, and if you look at the last four games, they played the Saints, Atlanta, Kansas City, and Tampa Bay. You could argue three or four of those are the best teams in the league right now. All right, so Bengals. Now, the Bengals I saw because they were on the Prop Me contest, and they're playing the Washington Football Club or whatever they're called now. So what do you – why – I don't think that surprises me as much because I'm a big Joe Burrow fan. But Blackhawk West, give us some more whys.
Well, there's a couple different ways that I look at this game. I mean, it's at one right now, and the – at least on the site I use, the action is lopsided. It's a -120 on Washington, and it's an even money on Cincinnati. So it may switch. I mean, when it gets to -120, sorry, I got greyhounds in the background. But when it's at -120,
I'll take the two. I always bet the two. Tommy always bets the one. I always bet the two.
I'm betting on them to calm down. That's where I'm at. But when you look at, when you see a game that's -120, it may shift to where it now becomes 1.5 or 2 in the favor of the other guy. So I think that by kickoff, this is going to be a 2-point dog, Cincinnati. But what I look at with Cincinnati, I'm going back to their worst loss of the season was 27-3 against Baltimore. They came back from that loss and went toe to toe with Indy. And Indy is a scary team for me. I'm a Chiefs fan, and I'm scared. Indy is the only team I'm truly scared of seeing in the playoffs. They're playing great defense, and they're the best team in the NFL, in my opinion, on O-line and D-line combination of the two. So Cincinnati comes back from a really big loss, and then they go against Indy, and they lost by 4, but they somehow found a way to put up 27 points against Indy's defense. But then I look at this past week, they lost 36-10 to Pittsburgh, which everybody's losing to Pittsburgh. I mean, somebody's going to beat them, but I'm not with my money. And so now they're going to go against Washington. And when you look at the statistics, Washington actually has a really good pass rush. They sacked the quarterback, and Joe Burrow has been sacked a lot. But I think when you look at Cincinnati statistically, they've played against a lot of good teams. They've only played two teams with losing records, and they beat one of them. The other one was the Chargers in week 1 before this Cincinnati team had really had a chance to gel. But there's been 3 games they've played against teams with losing records. The rest have been really big teams. So I think Burrow gets ahead early. Hey, shut up. I think Burrow gets ahead early coming off of a loss. And then we're looking at the Redskins, which is Alex Smith. That's a great story, good comeback story. But I watched Alex Smith as a Chiefs fan. Alex Smith is not a quarterback that will win the game. He won't lose the game. He won't cause turnovers. But he flat out can't win. So if they get a lead, I think that Washington's going to struggle playing from behind. I think that the 1 point and even money is a gift for Joe Burrow. I mean, he is playing really well with almost nothing to help him out.
Yeah, I can't argue with any of that. And again, Alex Smith, don't get me wrong. I like Alex Smith. He's a great quarterback, but you know, he used to be younger. When he was younger, he was faster. And when he was faster, he could do damage with his legs. And I watched him because I was actually he came in earlier in the year. Remember, he came in a few weeks, maybe 5 weeks ago, when they had his kids in the stand and his wife was there, and he came in because the quarterback got hurt. I don't think he became the starter then. That was, like I said, about a month ago. And he looked good, but he doesn't scare you with his legs. And he used to scare me with his legs when I bet against him.
Well, that's just it, is he was able to do some things with his legs. And I go back to some of the games I've watched him in KC where he's had the ball with some late in the game with the opportunity to get him in field goal range. And they're on their own 35. And, you know, somehow he just can't do it. And, you know, Alex Smith is great when they have the lead, but I just don't know that Washington's going to get the lead in this game because of the way Cincinnati, I feel, will respond to the loss they had last week. And as we've talked about, they don't lose them all. They don't win them all. Cincinnati is not going to lose them all. And they got probably two or three more W's coming out of the next eight games. So I like my chances there in winning two or three games out of the next eight. So I think this is the spot that they do it.
All right. So what we're going to do here is we're going to go through some of these prop me props. We already talked about the Cincinnati-Washington game, and we'll go back and forth. So on the next one, it'll be Muhammad, and then it'll be West, then Muhammad, then West. We'll do that easy. I'm going to stay out of it because, actually, last weekend, I forgot to make my plays. It was my birthday. I had a great birthday, and I look, and I'm saying, how come they're not? Because the best part about Prop Me, the app is worth it, even if you only get a couple right, because they send you a notification that says you're a winner. We have wives and boyfriends and girlfriends and kids in our lives that never say those words to us. That app makes me feel like I'm vindicated, like it's life is worth living. So I appreciate it. All right. So we got Atlanta at New Orleans, and I think the line's at 5.5. Mohammed, will New Orleans beat Atlanta by 5.5?
Yes. Yes, they will. I took a loss on it last week. I thought they weren't good. 10 points is where they were at last week. And I went the other way with San Francisco, but I've got them covering the 5.5.
Next game is Pittsburgh at Jacksonville. It's 10.5 points. Pittsburgh's pretty good, but 10.5 is a lot of points. Wes, will they cover, yes or no?
Every time I'll take the dog in the points. I think that Pittsburgh and Jacksonville both play to the level of their opponent. I think Pittsburgh wins by 9 or 10, and I think that maybe they rest players late, but that's just too many. 10.5 points to me is Patrick Mahomes, Russell Wilson, and in certain spots, Aaron Rodgers.
So, next game is Jacksonville. Philly at Cleveland. Will this game go over 47.5, Mohammed, yes or no?
No. I mean, if you look at what Cleveland did last week, I think they put up 7 points, 10 points. I don't see it happening. There's something wrong with that offense in Philly. I'm not a believer in Carson Wentz. He's overpaid and overrated, in my opinion.
If you had that Cleveland game under last week, that was one of just the greatest, greatest games to watch because it never, of course, it got delayed, but it never threatened, even coming close to being an over.
Nope.
All right, Tennessee at Baltimore, it's 6.5. Will Baltimore beat Tennessee West by 6.5? Yes or no?
I think that Baltimore will, only because of where they're coming from last week. Baltimore was in a primetime game against New England, and they lost, and they looked pretty bad doing it. Lamar Jackson is not as bad as he's playing. That Tennessee defense is just begging for some short passes over the middle. And, you know, I think Lamar can beat them. I like Baltimore in this position. I think it's 6 or 6.5, but I definitely like them, especially at home. At home is when they tend to light it up pretty good. On the road, I would call for a short win and take the other guy. But at home, I think Baltimore and the defense will show up a little bit, and they're going to have a chip on their shoulder after what happened last week.
All right, so we looks like we got an L. For that, we took the points in the first quarter. I'm gonna pay attention to this game. I don't think I'm gonna touch anything. Even if Seattle were to go down here and score, even if Arizona ties it up, I think I'm gonna hold off on this game and look at some data for the second half and come back in the second half. But we got two more games I want to talk about before we go. They are Kansas City at Oakland and it looks like Kansas City's given 7.5. Mohammed, that's perfect that I gave it to you, because Wes tends to be right on top of Kansas City. He knows when to bet him, when not to bet him. You're wearing the hat. So what do you think?
It's Kansas City, and I don't think it's close. If there's anywhere where you can find 10 and a hook, take it. They're coming off of a bye. Andy Reid is one of the best coaches in the league. They lost to them. That's the only loss they've got this week. And not to mention the victory laps that they took around the stadium. It's Kansas City, and I think they're going to blow them out.
I tell you, I love that. I love doing that alternate line. I really do. Because it allows you to then to really get some odds, especially if I'll go 7.5, 8.5, 9.5, almost like when we were betting baseball. Remember, Wes, you get 4 or 5 bets in a row, bang, bang, bang.
Oh, and that was great. I mean, you hit two of them, you hit one of them, but it paid the same way two would. So why not have another?
No doubt. No doubt. All right. Before we let you go, Mohammed, thank you very much for joining us. Appreciate your wise. The wise, here's the thing. Your whys are so important when you're sports betting, and really in any reason of life. When you say why you did something, it should be a why that at least the other person can respect. Because when your whys are totally wrong, you know, I really like the color of their new uniforms. It really takes my money, and it makes me want to go the opposite way. So hopefully you can join us again. Good luck this weekend. We'll talk soon.
Absolutely.
Blackhawk West, same thing with you. You know, we appreciate your contacts throughout the week, and I would assume that you and I will be talking this weekend, and hopefully you'll be cashing a lot of tickets.
You too. Cash some tickets, brother.
And remember, you can always catch us on Belly Up Sports Podcast Network at sportsbettingweeklylive.com. We're really everywhere, and we've just opinions, but there's as many opinions as one show can handle, and we'll talk to you next time. Thanks for listening.